remember the first time I landed at Mickey. Must be in July 1st week or so of 1977. One thing is getting a seat. So you got a seat, so you were very, very happy. And probably I applied only one or two places and I got the DTI selection list. So you were very happy. But the moment you landed here, the taxi gets down. Immediately people are, immediately somebody take your luggage. Come sir, I'll show your room. And he puts you in the your own independent room. Right? And go niche, you've got the tea in the mess. Probably it is a turning point in my life. So from that moment onwards, it is always an upward journey in the life, a different life from a low middle class family life of a distant to a different family. Then I had a challenge in life. I completed NITI and went home, and immediately within 2 days, my father and dad had the cancer. And we lost him very quickly. So I, even though I know my father had a cancer, I still immediately went to join the job in Ahmedabad from Kakinada. And within few days, he died. Within 10 days, I had to travel back and stay. And my whole family is on my shoulders because I am the eldest son of a 7-member family. Well, we were able to take up that particular challenge, whatever it is, and overall in the life, to come a long way. So joining, coming into NITI and getting into NITI hostel, I would say, is a turning point in my life. Then I can immediately come to today, and as I am completing my regular service, I am very happy today. Very happy because I have taken care of my family responsibilities reasonably well, despite so many limitations and so many handicaps, so much of ignorance that I may be having about many family members. Even in the professional career, I think I have reached an unexpected level. As far as I'm concerned, 20 years back, 10 years back, 5 years back, if I am thinking of what I am going to reach, and today what I reached is unexpected. Right? Every day morning, the topmost persons in America, they are going to come and put a like on my statements which I put in the LinkedIn. Unimaginable. They don't have to put on what I write, they don't have to put on a like on what I write. But it is like, it's God's grace or God's gift that today I can feel really, really happy. Even today, I am very confident that I have a capability and a competence that I will do something more to the society. Many things I do are purely very, very random occurrences. There is absolutely no reason, nothing. Suddenly you are sleeping and you get up and you feel I should do this. And immediately you start doing it. So on one night I am sleeping and said one day after an afternoon, right, on May 19th, suddenly I got up and said I should run an online course on industry engineering. Right? Immediately I am getting it under control. I want to run listed. So immediately go and take it down and try to create and announce an online course and start giving one lesson every day. So last year I started. So till December, January I have done, then I became very weak in that particular process. So once again, from the June 1st onwards, I have now once again restarted that particular thing. And this year, I wanted to put a target, and I said 50 people should read each and every lesson what I am trying to write. Around 3 to 350 lessons I am going to write, and 50 people should read each lesson. So that is my target. And so far it is going at the rate of 25 people. Today is the 60th day, and today is the 60th lesson which is posted in the social media, and the that particular. Even principles of industrial engineering is just random. I went to my house for my 60th birthday celebration, and morning my mother is trying to call from somewhere, come, I'll give you a head bath. And that is the time, just 2 minutes before I got the idea that Taylor's principles of scientific management should be converted into principles of industrial engineering. You say father of industrial engineering, Taylor, but there is no principles of industrial engineering. In the discipline of industrial engineering, there are no principles of industrial engineering. That is the justice part, right? And my mother is calling, come quickly. I said, no, I have to write most important thing, just wait. So immediately I write the 6 points I wanted to write and go ahead. Then after 6 months we are giving a conference paper. So I submitted a conference paper. So they have written a comment, somebody, that conclusion is very brief. So in the conclusion I added these 6 points. And then I went to make a presentation. Professor Sachin Kamble was there in that particular thing. And then I thought, I'm going to expand the 6 principles of Taylor into a longer list like Henry Fayol. Henry Fayol has given 14 principles, Taylor has given 4 principles. So I should expand it into a longer list. So when ISE conference has come, I sat down, tried to do that listing. I always felt that I may not be up to the mark. And what I am sending from my name on NITI should always be good. And that is the reason why I used to go to any of the faculty and say, go please, read my paper. Only if you say it is good, I am going to put it outside. If you say no, it's nonsense, then it is nonsense. But most of it I am lucky. People have cleared and said, yes, sir, there is some content in it. You can modify like this, you can modify like this, do this, something like this thing. So I have given 21 principles and I was told to 5 people in the institute. Before sending it, I to show to 5 people. Right? Then only, yes, it has a reasonable content to send it. Now when you send it, what happened? I gave the conference presentation. I got a video camera. There is a video is ready. I put a video. Right? So the first comment is written. Right? Probably it should not have been approved to this conference. Somebody has not seen it properly. When the review was there, wonderful. The reviewer has written the paper is wonderful, it is long overdue. That was the reviewer's comment. But somebody has written that. I must have felt very, very bad. What is this? Publicly I have put in a LinkedIn and somebody has put like this. But probably within the day, there is one more comment saying that I am not able to listen to your video properly. Please send your PPT to me. Okay? I sent a PPT. He sent an email. I got an email answer. It is very good. I support what you said. Right? Who is that man? I don't know. You know? I just tried to see something in that this thing. Gideon Halevi, I don't know. Still, I must have seen something on something is there on, online, some book or something like that. So I sent a mail to him. Sir, thank you for giving this. I am going to write in my blogs about this thing. Right? And then one or two things have come, and then I realized he is some 90-year-old man, Israel professor, so great a professor. He has written some 10, 20 books and all that sort of thing. Right? And then there were so many wonderful comments, etc., etc. has happened. Today that video has got 6,750 views. So sometimes you suffer. Fine. So this is one thing. As a professional, I would say it is. This recently, I wanted to write an article, and I thought that computer-aided industrial engineering should have been there. It is not there. And I created an abstract, sent it to Professor Michael Grover. Right? And Michael Grover said, yes, you try to write it, whatever is the concept. Yes, I agree that it has some value. You please go and do that particular this. So that's why I say professionalism. The other thing I feel good is about my national level issues. I have created something on the $20 trillion. I am very much in favor of the Make in India below the 20 trillion. I am very much in favor of Mudra Finance. And all these three things, I have research papers, I have publication, I have videos which are there available on the YouTube. And I even correspond with the all ministers. We are in the Twitter, we are in the Facebook account, I tell them this scheme good, Mudra Finance, please take it forward and do it. And I go and tell even district level political leaders or even MP. When MP came to my house, because election canvassing is there, and I told him that, sir, I have sent an email to you regarding Mudra Finance. Please have a look at it. And it can be taken forward. Right? Each of these issues that I am talking of the $20 trillion Indian economy, or Make in India, or Mudra Finance, I still have a lot to contribute. I am seeing today what I wrote on the 20 trillion economy, and there is an Exim Bank lecture in 2015 in which there is a sentence, sustained productivity is required to reach this particular place. Right? Is it there? I once again today checked, counter checked, is it there by a foreign expert who told that India will do well, but a sustained increase in productivity is required. So the earlier reference I have given is a video, it is not there. But then I have found two more references of Business Standard or Times of India, and I added there. Why I specifically want to say that is, recently in the month of January, February, March, Honorable Minister Piyush Goyalji, he created a massive exercise in this country. In 40 industrial sectors, he got the people come and discuss regarding quality and productivity. And I tried to participate very, very actively in those particular online discussions after 23rd weakness. So I could not. But I would like to take it forward. That's so whatever is my happiness, what I would like to convey to my colleagues. I hear sometimes it is all thankless service. This is one sort of a statement we do sometimes. But personally today I tell you, whatever I have done, I have received enough thanks. I have received enough thanks personally from my students, MDP participants or company participants and my colleagues. I have no complaints. Right? I have not received thanks, I have not recognized, my work is not recognized. No such complaints. Right? Enough of the work is recognized. And I want to tell to my colleagues, right? Whatever you believe, keep doing it. Right? Whatever you believe, you keep doing it in a positive manner. Definitely, a certain recognition will come. I am very, very soft man, I am very innocent man. I am not any smart man or like that. So if I can get enough recognition, you see, I got an article published in a book which has articles by ministers like Murali Manohar Joshi, Devendra Fadnavis, Raghuveer Jha, and all that. And how that article has come? Somebody asked me, give a lecture. Give a lecture on communism and Deendayal's philosophy. I said, both of them I don't know. How can I give? I'll give a lecture on capitalism and Deendayal. At least I'm Professor Bolle's student. I must have learned some economics, so I'm able to speak. And okay, I prepared and gave a lecture. And immediately somebody came and told me that you please give it in writing, we are going to publish it. I said everything is written, article is ready. I prepared proper article and then only give the lecture. I gave it to them and immediately it is there. It is there as a part of that book, one of the 50 essays along with the topmost people in the country, in the area of political thinking. My effort is not there, right? So I don't want to complain about recognition. My request to all colleagues is keep doing. Students, see, okay, sometimes we complain, but still I feel whatever I told to my students, they have tried to do. I only feel bad today, how did they get it done? PhD students, I told on your topic in the first 6 months, you are going to read 10 papers and make a brief review and make a presentation in the class. 10 papers on the area of his research topic. In the first semester, he has to make a presentation in the class. Half an hour, 10 papers. No complaints. Right? So I have to appreciate in PGP students. Today also we are full of papers. I am throwing many of them. I feel very, very bad. Right? Still I feel those papers value is there. So I appreciate all the students for trying to do whatever I told them to do. And that is from somewhere I have got that confidence today to write and present it on the global level without this thing and get an appreciation on the global level. Right? From all countries, including Japan. Right? Including Japan, I today have the support what I am writing. Right? Consultants, Tokyo consultants who are in industrial engineering and processing. Right. This is what is my statement of farewell to my colleagues. Right. Definitely your efforts will be appreciated. Try to. Then I would like to say specially about our professor, director sir, Professor Manoj Kumar Tiwari. The first time I met him, right, I am trying to come out of the lift and he is trying to come in, right, at meeting. And he said, hello, I have come here to serve you. This is the introduction that he makes on his own. He must have realized this fellow is stunned. He is coming out and suddenly is there. So he said, so I come here to serve you. Right? Sir has a strategy. Whenever I stop two or three times, he says, I know what is to be done. And I will do it. Right? For me, the David Sinchilevi, that particular global program, I would say it is a great strategic thinking and a big success for the NITI. Right? So that shows that you can do something. We have gone down in the training area, but maybe we have come up. Right. Personally, I did not learn supply chain management subject from a teacher. So listening to Sinchilevi is good. Right. Another thing is the data analytics. Now in the area of data analytics, I'm just telling somebody. Even in year 2001, I have colleagues who are talking about data mining, etc. Right. In SPJ, people were sitting beside me who are talking of data mining, etc. I was not listening to it because I am struggling in some other subject which I am looking at it. Right. So in 2015, when my daughter joined her CMU for a computer course, so there is something going on. Right. But still, I tried. I must have read some blog posts and all, data analytics, data mining, data science. I'm looking back even at that time I took it. But once our course has started, right, now definitely I have increased my understanding of that. So now I have a better understanding of what is machine learning, or what is data analytics, right? What is data science, what is happening. I am very, very confident that I can understand now better. So I appreciate sir for that personal, this thing is one, my personal benefit. But what I want to say is, it is the first time in NITI that a new area is being introduced to the entire NITI community at a single point. Right? All the faculty, all the research scholars, all the M.Tech students, right? The entire NITI is being provided an introduction to the concept, telling that, and I would say it is something in my mind that every time a new thing comes, you need to do this sort of an exercise. That every year you sit down and say what is new, right? And what is new should be told to the entire community. So I genuinely and sincerely appreciate the initiatives taken by sir, and I genuinely believe that the NITI will make a big progress because of his strategic thinking. And we are all there, I tell you. Whenever I meet him, I tell him, NITI faculty will always support. right? And I will always go and tell every ET faculty that we should be diligent and we have to do whatever is to be done, right? We will, right? Maybe we will be ineffective, right? I can tell, did I learn it once in data analytics? I may not have learned it. It may require I have to learn twice. Okay. Somebody else is still ineffective, he may take 5 times. Okay. As a teacher, I'm willing to give him once more or twice more. Right? That's fine. But as a group, what I would say is we have to support, right, the initiatives that are being taken. So once again, I'm very, very confident that under SAR's initiatives, the NITI will move forward. So I'm very happy today to listen to all of you, the nice things that you have told about me. And in NITI, right from the security gate to the highest level of director's seat, I always got cooperation. Right? But people used to wonder, if you apply, why you are getting UBP? I said, I'm not doing anything. UBP has come. Whenever something comes which I can teach, I say I want this. Other areas, I don't write. I write only specific area where I feel confident, I write. If they give, I do it. And whenever I have done my programs, I used to specially go to people and pick and say, you have to take. And people have always cooperated with me. And no program, I have got any problem of running that particular program. I'm very, very happy with my teaching colleagues, with my non-teaching colleagues. I never had problem with anybody, I have no complaints with anybody rarely in the non-teaching side or teaching side, right? And computer, whatever computer I got, whatever internet facility I got, I never complained. That is more than sufficient for me to do my work. Never I had any sort of a complaint about the computers and the internet group. So I am very, very happy. I have no complaints, and I don't think anybody has really fought with me on his issue, right? So tomorrow I can come anytime I want to come without any issues. I can enter the institute and be happily talk to people and go, right? I'm really, really thankful to all of you. Thank you.